in order for this concert to live on, coaches shouldn't act as a fan but with their respect, fairness, honesty, and responsibility before, during, and after all athletic contests.
They might.
Hello and welcome back to Trustmark Arena. We've got a great game here today between Christian Brothers University and the Montevallo Falcons. I'm Sarah Turner, joined by Aiden Golden. Aiden, what are some things we can be looking out for today?
Well, Sarah, the first thing we can look out for is that the Falcons here have to win out. You know, these last five games are very important. We got the last home game coming up this Saturday and then a big away streak coming up. Secondly, Falcons are going to have to really find someone to step up on defense. Last game we saw Aiden Garner go out, and then also in that game we saw Mason Shiflett did not get the start, having a concussion. And finally, they're going to have to really play full court defense. This Christian Brothers offense is a very tough team, so someone's going to have to step up here.
Absolutely. Join us back here shortly on the Falcon Athletics Network for tip-off.
Number 15.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Trustmark Arena. I'm Aiden Golden. I'm joined with Sarah Turner.
Number 20, Nick Dykel.
Tonight we have a very interesting game, another rematch between.
Number 21, Dario Johnson.
Between Christian Brothers University and.
Christian Brothers is coached by John T. Rock with assistant coach Chris Davis.
Yeah, this should be a great game today. We've got some of the starters out for you.
Starting off
and
Christian.
Now, please welcome tonight's starters for your Montevallo Falcons. A 6'3 graduate guard from Fort Collins, Colorado. Number one, Preston Bertolette.
The Falcons, a typical starting lineup. Braxton Bertolette, star on offense. From Montevallo, we've got number three, James McNeil, another offensive prowess.
Queens, New York.
We've got
number
freshman
three,
Tyler Moore
J-C
out there. Also, Jalen Tharp, number 13. And Mason Shiflett will be back, returning from a concussion.
A
missed the last
guard
game.
Tennessee.
Gets
four,
shorter, 76 to 74,
four,
due to that injury. And Christian Brothers, we've got number 21, Daryl Johnson.
A 6'2 graduate guard from Clarksville, Tennessee. Number
10,
Madison
Monroe. Number 15, Slate Garmany. Number 20, Nick Diefel.
And a 6'5 sophomore from Sarrisville, Kentucky. Number 24, Mason Shiflett.
We're just about ready for tip-off here. Mason Shiflett on the tip for the Falcons.
And Christian Brothers wins it right away. That is Slate. Slate Harmony. Missed there, but that was Nick Dyfel. Dyfel tried to shoot off a three and it went out of bounds. And it is Falcons ball now. Moore with the ball for the Falcons.
Falcons are coming into this game 9-14, 7-12 in Gulf South play, sitting at 10th place in the conference right now outside of playoff contention.
McNeil was down low. He put it up but draws the foul.
They're coming off of a tough stretch of games. Their last game was that 76 to 74 loss here versus Shorter last week.
That one on Slate Garmany.
McNeil out here early, some free throw attempts. He's a 73% free throw shooter on the season. Guy who's averaging 12 points a game for the Falcons.
McNeil misses that one as well. Sacks over to Monroe, now back to Garmany. Sacks drives in, now back out to Garmany. Garmany lost control, but luckily that is Daryl Johnson able to lay that one in for two for Christian Brothers. Tyler Moore with the ball. Drives in, get the ball poked away by Nick Dyfel. Dyfel now with the ball in the corner. Makes a move now over to Warner. Buccaneers are moving this ball around. It's Garmany. He drives in. Now dumps it back to Monroe. Rats. Shoots it. Misses. And Jalen Tharp getting called for a personal foul here. It's going to go right back to Buccaneers possession.
Buccaneers coming into this game 4-17, 4-14 in conference play, sitting in 12th place in the conference, just below Montevallo.
And that is Johnson again, able to lay that one in for two.
And their last game was 67-66 win, nail biter against West Florida, team that Montevallo plays next week.
Shiflett now from deep. Swish.
And Mason Shiflett is back, everybody. Missed last game due to a concussion. These guys averaging 12 points a game as well for the Falcons. Super key on offense and defense for the Falcons. He's 10th in the conference in rebounds.
Mason Shiflett definitely saying, I'm back, and you're not going to like it, as he got that steal there. And now he pops, shoots. Oh, he almost makes another. Tyler Moore was under the basket to get the rebound. Now the ball is just being bumped around. And finally, Christian Brothers does end up with the ball. It's Garmany. Garmany drives in, steps back out to Ratsatz. Ratsatz. Dyfel from the corner. Misses. Into the hands of Monroe. Monroe now shoots from the corner, misses. Back out to him. Falcons just allowing the Buccaneers here to just gain their rebounds back really easily. Monroe drives in, but he gets called for travel.
Yeah, we know defense is something that Montevallo struggles with. They're giving up, on average, 81 points a game, 13th in the conference in defense. But their offense, we know, can get so hot, averaging 77 points a game, second in the Gulf South. Falcons have been struggling to close out games. We'll see what they can do here tonight against the Bucks.
Tyler Moore. Now to Shiflett, now over to McNeil now. McNeil trying to find an open man. Shiflett with the ball. He's making moves, driving in, puts it up, misses, and Eiffel gets the rebound. Sats puts it up, misses. Burlett gets the defensive rebound. Burlett, one of the big men down here. And step back, fade swish. Wow. Wow, what a shot by Burlett.
Erickson Burlett, can't say enough about him. Averaging 21 points a game, first in the conference in offensive production, 48% in field goals, 10th in the conference in that respect this season.
Garmany just able to just easily lay that one in. Burlett now gives off to Tharp and Tyler Moore. Yeah. Shiflett trying to drive in, lays it up, misses. On the court now is number 11. That's Charlie Champagne for the Bucks. Ratsatz shoots a three, misses, and we're going to have a foul call. Doubt fouls on Daryl Johnson. We're going to have a media timeout here. Score 5-6.
Low scoring. First 5 minutes for both teams. Back here, 15 minutes left to play in this first half.
Some new players for both teams. Kenda Knight checks into the game for the Falcons, as well as Aiden Gardner for the Buccaneers. I see that's number 24. It looks to be Daniel Luce.
Kenda Knight stepped up in a big way last Thursday against Shorter with the loss of Mason Shiflett and Aiden Gardner coming out at the half, putting up some big numbers on the rebound for Montevallo. And all of CBU's points tonight haven't scored in the paint.
That's out to Dyfel. Now Carmony tried to get it down low to Luce, and Gardner gets the steal there. Shiflett now with the ball. He's going to hand it back off to McNeil. Now to Starman. Bertolette. Trying to double cover Berlette, it's standing out of Knight. Knight shoots it, misses, into the hands of McNeil. In for two. J.C. McNeil.
I think they'll have 15 points in Montevallo's loss last week against Shorter.
And now it's Dyfel with the ball, gets it off to Ratsatz. It's a shot from number 11. That's Champagne. Champagne misses. Bertolette shoots another floater, misses, and Champagne gets the rebound. Dyfel with the ball, and he's going to get called out of bounds. Bertolette will be on the inbound for the Falcons. Shiflett now with the ball. Shiflett shoots under. Just a little bit short. Goes off the front end of the rim. Cross court over the Ruthsats. Down low to Luce. Back out to Germani. Now to Ruthsats. And Knight gets the rebound.
Great rebound from Kenda Knight.
McNeil now with the ball. Bertolette shoots. He misses, but Gardner gets the offensive rebound.
Coach Kamara telling his Falcons to pick up the pace.
It's on the slow down the shot clock. McNeil shoots in and out, and Champagne able to get the rebound. And now Ruth again with the ball, now with a Dyfel. Ruth sets.
Aiden Gardner called on a foul.
Aiden Gardner. Third personal team foul, number two.
Gardner now coming off, and Tharp goes back in. They're coming on for the Buccaneers was Luke Gadowski. Three-pointer from Champagne, and he easily makes that one. For two, my bad. That one was for two, not three. With the ball now, as Burlett gives it off to McNeil. Tharp from the corner shoots, swish.
Montevallo, 33% from distance on the season. 10th in the Gulf South. Great shot from Tharp there. Bring the Falcons lead up to two.
Buccaneers really just trying to create ball movement around the point. And McNeil will draw the foul or get called for a foul. And we're going to have a media timeout. Score 10-8 in favor of the Falcons with just 11:27 left to play. Christian Brothers ball here on our side, right in front of press row. Checking it in is Champagne. He's going to check it in to Luke Gadowski. Stats with the ball. He wanted to get it to Gadowski, but Moore read it perfectly, and now a foul call. That's on Ruth Gatz. Ruth Stats.
Second personal team foul, number three.
Madison Monroe will check back into the game.
Number 10, Madison Monroe.
Moore with the ball for the Falcons. He's at the night. Night out to Bertolette. McNeil fakes. Now gives it to Bertolette, who shoots in coverage and makes it.
Paxton Bertolette. Incredible three shot, 38% from distance this season. He's ninth in the conference in threes.
Don't charge it!
Through
the high post!
Ruth Satz now to That's a good basketball. Cross court pass over to Madison. Now Rusatz from the corner makes it. Moore now with the ball. He's going to hand it off to Bertolette. Bertolette, step back, fade, in and out, into the hands of Johnson. Rusatz now over to Gudowski, drives in, puts it up, misses, and Tharp gets the rebound for the Falcons. McNeil with the ball now. He's driving to the basket. Out to Tharp. Tharp for three. Swish!
Jalen!
Montevallo 4 for 6 from distance so far.
Rusatz with the ball. Gives off to Monroe. Rusatz again with the ball. He shoots while covered and makes it.
Actually, Christian Brothers' first three make of the game. 1 for 8.
Gives it off to McNeil. Over to Bertolette. Bertolette from deep. In and out. And looks like we're going to have a personal foul on Jalen Tharp.
Jalen Tharp questioning that call with the official.
Shiflett now coming in. Rusatz now with the ball again. Gives off to Gudowski. Now Monroe. Champagne. And we're going to have a foul.
Hey, boss man! Boss man!
That one's going to go on McNeil.
McNeil's second personal the game so far. Falcons up 16-15, 8:40 left to play in this first half.
He's going to get it into Johnson, but Johnson trying to now move in, puts it up, misses, and Shiflett gets the defensive rebound.
Shiflett showing how great of a rebounder he is.
Euro step, and it's going to be an offensive foul on Shiflett. Interesting call there.
Offensive foul number 24, as Shiflett, his first personal team foul number 6.
Saps again with the ball for the Buccaneers. Down low to Johnson. Johnson's going to get it back out to Gudowski. Now it's Champagne from the corner. Misses. And McNeil gets the rebound for the Falcons. Shiflett drives in. Steps back and puts it in off the glass. Saw about three Buccaneers there trip up.
Shiflett 5 points now for Montevallo and his return back from injury.
Monroe now with the ball. Now with the Rusatz. Rusatz cross court to Champagne. Champagne. Rusatz again with the ball. 8 seconds. Monroe floater out. And Johnson does get the rebound. Oh, shoving match going on here.
Force a timeout.
Media timeout.
Might see some fouls here.
Might see a technical. Don't know yet. The refs are talking about it.
Let's see on the replay here. Great shot from Jalen Tharp.
I wonder if we'll get to see the replay on the recent thing. So we will have a foul on Tharp. And Again, like we said, the refs will be checking to see what the call is. Still waiting on a call from the refs about if we have a technical on either team. Started off with Jalen Tharp, and I think that was Johnson. Johnson got into Tharp's face, and Tharp chirped back, and they started shoving, and Shiflett got involved, and then suddenly we saw that everyone was having to be pulled apart. Only 7:35 left here to play. Down at the replay station. Let's go to Joe. Refs again, taking their time. Want to make sure they make the right call here, it seems.
Call is going to be. The referee's still looking at the replay. Falcons hitting 41% from the floor right now, 7 for 17 in those field goals.
And one ref steps away from the replay station, and another one goes in. If I had to think, I think they just need to start queuing up the Jeopardy music.
And we're missing the pep band here today. Last time these two teams met, Montevallo lost 91-76. Montevallo was hitting 38% in those field goals. Only 18% from three. Usually this is a team that's averaging 33% from distance.
So a decision has been made. Still waiting to see what we're going to get here. So we do have Jalen Tharp foul. That is confirmed. Double technical. Possible double technical.
Will be Johnson at the line. Johnson with 6 points tonight so far for the Bucks.
I think we do have confirmation.
Personal foul number 13, Jalen Tharp. His third personal, team foul number 7. Technical foul on the number 24, Mason Shiflett, and number 21, Dario Johnson.
So we
both
do
their first technicals, second fouls.
So we do get the double technical that's between Johnson and Shiflett. Shoot, and he shot for one, Johnson, and he missed. And now it's McNeil with the ball. He's going to give it off to Knight. McNeil, he's driving into the basket, lays up and in for two.
J.C. McNeil.
J.C. McNeil, 53% from the floor this season. Up to 4 points tonight.
Ruth Satz gives it off to Dyfel. And now it's Monroe. That is Champagne missed, but Johnson was able to put that one back in for two. Knight over to Tyler Moore. Tyler Moore trying to dive in across the court to Bertolet. Bertolet shoots. Swish! All I can say is, I'm just giving this man a round of applause.
Braxton Bertolet, 8 points on the night so far. He had 31 in that loss against Shorter. An incredible night for him, an unfortunate way for them to go out in that game. He hit that three with 21 seconds left to play.
Dyfel makes a three.
Montevallo's 3 for 4.
Dyfel shoots cleanly in. McNeil now with the ball. Bertolet shoots, it misses, and Johnson gets the rebound defensively. Ruth Satz with the ball now, gets it over to Dyfel. Dyfel again shoots, he misses, and Knight gets the rebound. Shiflett now drives in, puts it up, misses. Bertolet gets the rebound. Burlett's trying to do it all on his own, but finally gets it out to McNeil. McNeil got blocked. Now it's Dyfel with the ball. Now Monroe, now Johnson. Johnson finger rolls, misses, and Shiflett gets the rebound.
Shiflett is so key on those defensive rebounds. Definitely a key factor to that loss last week. Having him could have changed the outcome for sure for the Falcons.
Ruth Satz getting called on a personal foul there. It's going to send Shiflett to the inbound. And Aiden Gardner checks into the game. Yeah. McNeil with the ball now. McNeil makes a move, goes in, shoots, misses. No foul called. Ruth Satz with the ball.
Coach Camara with some words to the officials, looking for a foul on that last play.
Gudowski drives, spin, puts it up, misses. Now it's McNeil, now over to Moore. Moore drives in, that slows down, puts it up, and in for two.
Tyler Moore's first points of the night. Leading to a CBU timeout. Game is tied 25-25. 3:48 left to play. We'll see you back after the break.
Get ready to go back underway. It is Christian Brothers ball. Football pass to Luce. Luce started down.
Aiden Gardner can get there in time. Put a stop to that play.
Schifflin now with the ball. Puts it up. Misses. It's going to be an on-court foul. That one's on Luke Gudowski.
And it cut.
McNeil on the inbound. Shiflet.
He's off to Bertolette. Bertolette trying to make a move. Now gets it out to Shiflet. Shiflet trying to drive in. Personal foul on Daniel Luce. It's going to give Bertolet uncontested free throws here. And he makes it.
Rex and Bertolet. First trip to the free throw line tonight.
Man, that's automatic.
93% in the line, leading the Gulf South, leading Division II. One of the best players in Division II basketball right here in Trustmark tonight.
Gudowski was open and just walked right in. Gives it to Bertolet. Bertolet drives in. Puts it up. Misses. And it's rebounded by Champagne. Ruth Satz. Cross court over the Champagne. Champagne shoots, misses, but the foul is blown, or shot is blown off. Gardner getting called for a personal foul here. It's going to send Luce to the free throw line.
shooting 1-1 for Christian Brothers, number 24, Daniel Luce.
Daniel Luce shoots, misses. It's still going to be Christian Brothers ball. Gets it into Luce now, Champagne. Luce sat, steps back, fade, in and out. And now Gardner got the rebound.
Great rebound for Gardner.
With it, downloaded, more, puts it up, and in, and draws a foul. What a feed by Bernalette.
Taylor Moore, guys averaging 6 points a game. For Montevallo, 63% from the line. Montevallo's the best free throw shooting team in the conference, averaging 79% from the line this season.
Moore shoots, and he makes it. Now coming on is Kendon Knight. Ruth Satz with the ball. Warner now with the ball. Just trying to set up for a screen here. Bertolette gets the steal, read it like a book.
Jackson Bertolette with 27 steals on the season.
He shoots a little floater in and out, but Moore was there, puts it up, misses. Into the hands of Daniel Luce. And we have a personal foul.
CBU is doing a really good job of keeping up with this Falcon offense.
That's Kendon Knight. That was on Kendon Knight, and that's his first personal foul.
Christian Brothers averaging 65 points a game.
Shooting two for Christian Brothers, number 24, Daniel Luce.
Daniel Luce shooting two here. His first one is up, and it's a miss. This one's up, and it's short! And everyone in Trustmark is making that one very well known for Luce. McNeil trying to get it tonight, and it seems like he just got shoved, and it was an errant pass there. Now it's Ruth Schatz with the ball.
Both teams with seven turnovers now after that steal.
Die full from the corner, swish. Cannot see who has the ball at Bertolette. Now over to McNeil. Back to Bertolette. More now McNeil, now to Knight. Out to McNeil. McNeil shoots. Swish! 3-by-3.
Great look from McNeil. Getting open. Find that shot.
Ruth Satz just going to hold on to this ball. Make sure that the Falcons don't get it again. Now to Champagne. Ruth Satz shoots from deep, misses. Dyfel into the hands of Moore. Moore's just going to heave this for fun.
That'll do it for your first half of basketball between Christian Brothers and Montevallo. Game tied at 32 even. We'll see you back here on the Falcon Athletics Network for the second half of this game.
gentlemen, welcome to the court, the Montevallo Elementary Dance Crew.
Destiny, on your mark,
Get set. Go. Layup. Good. Free throw shot. Free throw goes up. Good. 3-point shot. 3-point shot. Ooh, a little short. 3-point shot. No. 3-point shot. 13 seconds. No. It's in line. Just a little short. Oh, a little out to the right. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord. For the game. Free throw shot. I just don't think you can hear the fact she's like giggling the whole time. It's fantastic. No. Come on. Free throw. There it is. 3-point shot. 3-point shot. 3-point shot. Oh. Woo. Heads up. 3-point. 3-point. You got it. Ooh. Just a little bit more. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, no. She got hit in the face. All right. Allison's up next. Allison, layup. On your mark, get set, go. Layup is good. She hit it with confidence. Allison, free throw.
Montevallo is listed as one of the most beautiful public college campuses, but it has so much more than good looks. It's been named a College of Distinction 7 years running. Plus, it offers 75 majors and the chance to belong to more than 90 campus organizations. Visit youbelong at Montevallo.com to learn more.
Gain art school experience with a liberal arts education at the University of Montevallo. Visit montevallo.edu/COFA. Create your future in art. You belong at Montevallo. Your success depends upon effective communication. Visit montevallo.edu/COFA. You create your future in communication studies and mass communication. You belong at Montevallo.
In today's fast-paced world, it can be hard to find time for the news.
That's why we're committed to
making the news fit into your busy schedule.
Tune in each week to see the stories that impact your life.
And be sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
We are Valo Vision News.
Get in the box, they say. And shoot in the box. The box. Free throw. No. Oh. Wait, she just. She's left. Get the help out of this. Can't get more for the game. Thank you all for participating in the halftime shootout. And thank you for coming out and supporting your Falcons.
Welcome back to Trustmark Arena, ladies and gentlemen, for the start of the second half of play between the Christian Brothers Buccaneers and your Montevallo Falcons. Score is 32-32. Sarah, let's talk about that first half and some of our points going into this game.
That was a great half for both teams. It's a really close game, obviously, tied even at 32. Montevallo offense is rolling, but Christian Brothers has been doing a good job of keeping them a little bit limited. No one on the court in double digits so far.
Burlett is the closest. He is sitting at 9. McNeil drives in, puts it up and in for 2. That's how we should start it off. Now it's Ruth Stats with the ball. Gives it over to personal foul on Jalen Tharp. Jalen Tharp is on 4 personals now. He's on trouble of getting fouled out, and we're only in the early minutes of the first period. As cannot see who that is. That looked like Dyfel. Dyfel looked like from the corner and missed, and then Johnson able to lay that one in on Shiflett.
Yeah, Tharp and foul trouble is not something the Falcons want to see.
Shiflett trying to drive towards the basket.
So early in this second half.
Mason Shiflett!
Mason Shiflett easily laying that one in for 2.
Go,
Shiflett pointing to Coach Kamara that it was his fault for allowing Johnson to get that little easy two. McNeil drives in, and he misses. And Dyfel got the rebound there for the Buccaneers, and now it's Garmany with the ball. That was, seemed like Madison from deep, and Burlett got the defensive rebound. Now it's Tyler Moore with the ball. He lost control, but it might have went off on Ruth Satz, and it will be Falcons ball.
Hey, you know what it is? It's for Ward.
Burlett put that up, missed.
Montevallo with no bench points so far in this game. Surprising for this team.
It's going to be a jump ball. It's going to be Christian Brothers ball here. And Gardner checking into the game for Tharp.
Number 32, Aiden Gardner.
Get it into Johnson. Tommy. Ruth Spatz now. It is Dyfel in the corner. Back to Jarmany. Jarmany's trying to drive in. Gets it down low to Johnson. Johnson jumps in. Misses. Gets his own rebound. Puts it back up. Out. And Gardner gets the rebound. Shiflett with the ball now.
Set it.
Over to Bertolette. Bertolette shoots. Misses.
Shiflett hits the ground. The collision with Buccaneer. We'll have a CBU inbound.
That foul called on Shiflett.
Very personal, team foul, number two.
Shiflett up to three personals.
Don't think that's the first what he was expecting in his first game back.
Shiflett, super crafty player. He'll do the dirty work that a lot of other players won't do.
Gardner gets the rebound offensively. Falcons had to find the answer for Johnson. He's been able to just easily get the rebounds and put up the layups. Dyfel missed the three, and then Gardner blocked the shot from Monroe. Now it's Dyfel with the ball down low. Madison tries to put it up, misses. Now Moore has the rebound.
Aiden Gardner with 19 blocks in the season, 11th in the conference.
Shiflett with the ball now. He slips. And now it's Dyfel puts it up, and he draws the foul on Tyler Moore.
Personal foul number four, Tyler Moore. His first personal team foul number three.
It's Tyler Moore's first personal of the game.
Two for Christian Brothers, number 20, Nick Dyfel.
Dyfel will be shooting for two here.
Dyfel averages 11 points a game for CBU, 77% from the stripe.
Johnson, the first player to go into double digits for the Buccaneers. It seemed like Dyfel missed that first free throw, and he steps up for his second now. This one's up, and it's cleanly in.
Dyfel had 17 points in CBU's last game, their win against West Florida.
Shiflett with the ball, gets it to Gardner now with a Tyler. Down low to McNeil.
Taylor.
Ruth Satz shoots, misses. Rebound. It goes out on a Falcon and will be Buccaneers ball still.
Media timeout.
We're going to have a media timeout. 15:50. Just a little under 16 minutes left to play here. Score 36-37. No big move.
Got
We'll have CBU inbound, bring this game back into action.
Get out. And Dominique with the ball now getting left to reset. Dominique again. Into Dyfold. Dyfold drives in, steps back. Now drives in again. Now out to Monroe. Monroe from the corner. Swish.
Monroe averaging 10 points a game this season. It's 47% from distance. It's a great shot from him there. Gives CBU the lead, 40-36.
Tharp from the corner, shoots, misses. Gardner got the rebound. That one's on Dyfold. McNeil's on the inbound. He's going to get it into Tharp. Tharp trying to drive towards the basket. Does now back out to McNeil. McNeil shoots. Swish! 3-3.
McNeil, the first Falcon to get into double digits, sitting at 12 now.
Germany with the ball now. Steps back, gives a dive on now to the corner where Monroe is again. Monroe trying to drive, now gives it up. Seems like Dyfel has the ball again. Luce is in the game, by the way. Luce has checked in the game. Dyfel shoots, misses. Tharp gets the offensive rebound, or defensive rebound. Now Berlet with the ball. Tharp with the ball. He's off to Gardner. Now to Berlet. Berlet being double teamed here. Berlet drives in, floater, misses.
Braxton Berlet has yet to score in this second half.
Shiflett shoots, swish! Mason Shiflett.
Shiflett in double digits now. 10 points for him.
Sats.
Montevallo on a 6-0 run in these last 2 minutes.
I can't see who that was in the corner. That was Jarmany.
Jarmany, actually out of Pelham, Alabama. Transfer from Mississippi College.
Berlet with the ball. He's going to get it off to Gardner. Now to Shiflett. Shiflett can't shoot from the corner. We have a personal foul here. It's going to be. That's on Ruth Satz.
Personal foul number 5.
Dave Ruth Satz. His first
personal foul.
Champagne comes onto the court. Tharp now with the ball. Tharp puts up a little floater, misses, gets his rebound. Now to McNeil. McNeil shoots, misses, or it goes out. It goes off the rim and goes out the back. An offensive foul on Ruth Satz.
Going
to give the Falcons the ball back again.
We'll have Mason Shiflett inbounding here. Falcons only down by one. Good offensive possession here. Get themselves back up.
Gets it into Berlet. Now Shiflett again. Neil puts it up from the corner behind.
And
Freaking backboard.
Such a scrappy player down low, working against lots of bodies there to get the ball up and into the net.
Champagne with the ball, gives it off to Dyfer. Champagne shoots, misses, into the hands of McNeil.
Champagne moving all around the court looking for that ball.
Brulette shoots, misses, and Champagne gets the defensive rebound. Brulette stops it, and Gardner gets the defensive rebound. McNeil now with the ball, makes a move, drives in, puts it up, and in for two.
Fantastic offensive stretch for the Falcons. McNeil and Gardner and Bertolette all working together, string some points together. Falcons up 46-43, 11:54 left to play in this game.
Floating media timeout.
Let's see. That's tough work from McNeil.
Christian Brothers ball. Dyfel is on the inbound. Gets it into.
Falcons playing high press on that inbound.
Dyfel put it up, missed. Now Sats puts it in.
That's Sats averaging 11 points a game for Christian Brothers, 35% from distance.
Drives in, puts it up, and in!
Mason Shiflett!
Mason Shiflett getting very excited with making that.
Media timeout.
Drawing the foul that he just starts slapping the court in jubilation.
Mason Shiflett having himself a night. 12 points for him.
I just wanted to be able to see an accurate number.
Let's see. Great offensive play from Mason Shiflett, driving up through all that pressure. Get some points on the board, sitting at 14 points.
Thank you.
Shooting one for Montevallo, number 24.
See Mason Shiflett shooting one here.
Shiflett is 2 for 4 tonight at the charity line. This one is cleanly in. Going to get it into Ruth Stats. Trying to set up a screen.
McNeil and Moore both pressuring with Stats up there.
And Godowski got up and laid it in and drew one. That should be on Aiden Gardner.
Number 32, Aiden Gardner. His third question of team five, 4. Shooting one for Christian Brothers, number 13, Luke Godowski.
Puts this one around the world and in. Tied game again. Neil with the ball. McNeil is off to Moore. McNeil shoots, misses. And Ruth Stats gets the rebound. Now it's Champagne. Champagne puts it up and in for two.
Champagne's out of Florence, Alabama. Not too far from home.
Berlette with the ball. Gets it. Try to get it down low to Gardner. And Gardner drops a foul. That one's going to be on Champagne.
Hey, nobody does that. Nobody acts like that.
Brothers coach having a discussion with the officials. Aiden Gardner shooting some free throws here.
His first one is up and it's missed.
Officials giving CBU a delay of game.
Dyfel gets it into Rusatz. Good ask here. Back out to Rusatz. Dyfel now to Champagne. Champagne driving. Gets it out to Dyfel again. Now gets it down low to Luce, and Luce puts it in for two.
Huggins down by three. Both teams still very much in this game.
Wade hasn't gotten higher than four. That one goes off of Dyfel.
Way down the court.
Dyfel with the ball again. Now over to Gadowski. There's Sats again with the ball. Gets it down low to Luce. Luce goes up and puts it in for two.
Timeout here. Montevallo down 55-50, 9 minutes left to play.
Back underway from that short break. Score 55-50.
J.C. Bill.
Champagne with the ball. Sats drives in out to Gadowski. Back to Ruth Sats. And Tharp sticks his hand in and jams it out. And now it's Shiflett with that drives in. And it's an offensive foul on Shiflett.
Shiflett trying to talk that over with the official.
That's Shiflett's fourth personal now.
We'll see a CBU inbound here.
That's an interesting character, for sure. But Root Stats with the ball now gives it off to Dyfel. Gadowski back to Rusats. Champagne. He's looking to set up the screen there, but don't. Champagne trying to drive in. Cross court over to Rusats. Rusats shoots and clean the room.
Rusats 4-for-10 from three.
That's the biggest lead tonight. 6 points. It just shows that this has been a very defensive game, which was something I talked about. McNeil just easily lays that one in for two. But that was something I talked about in pregame, that this was going to have to be a very defensive game for the Falcons, as this Christian Brothers offense is just a really, really good all around.
Right, in these last few minutes is when the wheels start to come off for the Falcons defense. We've seen them give up leads before.
Dart gets the rebound. That's the problem. They have to really just keep going with that. You know, they got to snap back to that New Year tempo that they were just continuing to score as many points as possible in that first half. And now they're into a more defensive set point, but not necessarily showing it. And whoa, what a sequence of events. And no personal foul called on Knight. Coach Byron, the assistant coach Byron, and an offensive foul on the Buccaneers. That's on Daniel Luce. We're going to have a media timeout.
wild last stretch of plays for both teams. Falcons still down 58-54, 6:23 left to play. We'll see you back after the break. Braxton Bertolette inbound to Tyler Moore.
The Braxton magic is back on the court. Hoping he can make some noise here in the second half. McNeil pulls up, shoots, swish!
McNeil's been on fire tonight.
Just down by one now. Just down by one. McNeil hyping himself up after that make.
McNeil up at 21 points, as he should. Leading all scoring is McNeil.
Ruth Stats with the ball now. Drives in, puts it out to Dyfel. Dyfel shoots, miss, and Gardner gets the defensive rebound. McNeil now with the ball. This is now a swing in the motion for the Falcons.
Gardner now has 6 rebounds.
McNeil puts it up, misses, but draws a foul.
McNeil is still sitting in foul trouble. Not McNeil. McNeil only has 2 personal fouls.
McNeil steps up to the line for his first free throw. This one's up. And it's a miss. Comes right out to him. Visibly upset about that one.
Usually 73% from the line.
He's got to calm his nerves. Think about it going in, and he gets that one.
Score now tied at 58, the 9th tie of this game.
McNeil sticks his hand in there, trying to get the steal. Gabowski, Gadowski, out to Champagne, over to Roussas, now with a Dyfel. Dyfel cross court pass to Champagne. Champagne pulls up, shoots, and swish cleanly in.
Let's go, Falcons! Let's go!
Knight now with the ball, gives it off to Bertolette. Bertolette with the ball. Bertolette drives in, puts it up. Dyfel out to Roussats. Roussats miss, and McNeil gets his rebound. McNeil's driving in. It's going to be an offensive foul on McNeil.
Back up by 2. 4:22 left to play.
Yeah, we had had some pretty bad missed calls in the women's game, and now that we're seeing some bad calls from the ref, it seems. Ruth Satz with the ball. Drives in, puts it up, misses, and Moore gets the rebound defensively. You know, Moore hasn't been talked about all night, but he's an all-around great freshman.
Yeah, the fact that he's starting as a freshman says something to his talent. Guy's averaging 6 points a game. He's got five tonight.
10 seconds on the shot clock. McNeil tries to drive in. Now he's driving in again. Puts it up and in for two.
Huge night for J.C. McNeil. He's getting 24 points.
He's got a little bit of that fairy dust on him. Magic sparkles on that man. And it's going to go out of bounds. Or we have a media timeout instead. Score 60-60. 3:16 left to play. Interesting game so far. Come back onto the court. Dyfel from deep misses into the hands of Luce. And it's an on-court foul. Looks like that's going to be on Moore. Or no, Bertolette. That is on Tyler Moore, actually. Correction.
Christian Brothers, 2 for 7 from the line so far tonight. Team that usually averages 64%.
Luce again airballs on a free throw.
Falcon faithful really enjoying that miss.
McNeil now.
McNeil's played every minute of this game. It's showing with his 24 points.
McNeil's not the only one. It seems like Aiden Ruthsatz. Foot. That was Bertolette. Bertolette shoots, misses.
Bertolette still hasn't put up any points in the second half. 2:44 left to play. Game tied at 60, but we know Braxton Bertolette can come up clutch in big moments.
You know, that was one thing I discussed in the pregame. Big moments with big needs, big players, and we might have one tonight again. You never know. Gets it down to Luce. Now back out to Luce Satz. Luce Satz drives in, puts it up, misses. And Moore gets the rebound. Tyler Moore just being effective on the court for the Falcons.
Let's go, Falcons!
Gardner with the ball.
Falcons slowing down the tempo.
Gets it down to Gardner. Gardner's going to try to dribble in. Misses, puts it up. And in for two. Big man Gardner. Big man Gardner from down under. Puts it in for two. And just like that, Falcons back up with minute 40 left. Christian Brothers going to try everything they can to get back up ahead.
Falcons need to stop here.
It's set. Got the champagne, champagne. Jumper shoots, misses. But he will go to the free throw line.
Christian
That's
Brothers.
On JC.
Christian Brothers 12th in the conference in free throw shooting.
That's JC's fourth. We got, again, four players in foul trouble, just like the last game.
And McNeil, Shiflett, and Tharp all sitting at four. Definitely players we can't afford to lose in these last remaining minutes of this game.
I think they're going to review this. I think this is the right call. They want to review and make sure this is the right call.
Call that a foul on McNeil.
Let's go, Falcons! Let's go!
Why did I have to get him out? But he doesn't.
I think that's the second delay of game. Delay of game. Delay of game.
We'll see.
Shooting three for Christian Brothers, number 11, Charlie Champagne.
Questionable call from the referee. We'll see this again here.
As
McNeil.
I agree.
McNeil doesn't seem to touch loose there. Champagne.
This is his last one. He missed his first one, which you can hear. You heard the crowd go crazy for. And then he makes a second. Now this one is up. And he makes that one. Game's tied again with just a minute 25 left.
Go Falcons!
Burlett with the ball now, trying to drive in. Floater misses, comes out to Champagne.
Burlett still with no points in the second half.
I think everyone needs to just reach over, put a hand on Bertolette, and put on that trust mark magic for him. Shot clock at 10. Gadowski trying to drive in. Gets it out to Dyfel. From the corner, it's Champagne. Champagne in and out. Shiflett gets the rebound. Shiflett's on a fast break. Eurostep puts it up, misses.
33 seconds left.
Most of the fans here at Trustmark on their feet. We have one possession left. Ruth Stats is going to hold on to this ball as long as he can, but like I said, it's going to be a one possession game as that clock is ahead of the shot clock. Gudowski drives in. Little floater, misses, comes out to Moore. Tyler Moore, he's running up the court. He's on a fast break. Eurostats puts it up. It goes out.
And Moore had the chance to bring the win home. Frustrated with himself, but we will see again. Overtime in this game.
Second game this season go to overtime.
We took Lee into overtime. Number one ranked team in the conference. Fortunately did drop that game, the Falcons did, to Lee.
my new question is, are any of them?
Yeah, tied it. Tied at halftime, tied at the end of the game. So we get 5 minutes of overtime. Both teams both have exactly 24 field goals. Yet again, something we still need to point out is that we have three players in foul trouble with Shiflett, Clark, and McNeil.
Yeah, obviously key players, McNeil with 24 points, Shiflett with 15. Both of those top two on the court right now for the Falcons. Rex Myrtlett didn't put up any points in that second half.
I did not see Johnson at all in some of that second period, except for the beginning. And he's not back out again. They're going with that same lineup that was just out there in this final 10 minutes of play.
So we'll have 5 more minutes of basketball. See if the Falcons can come up with something.
And they stick Gardner on the jump shot, jump off here.
Let's go, Raven!
And Aiden wins the tip-off for the start of overtime. 4:50. We got 5 minutes to play here. Gardner with the ball. Gets it to Shiflett. Now to Moore. Hands it off to McNeil. Moore's driving in. Step back shot. Switch!
Moore sinks that one. Redemption. In that last redemption few seconds of regulation.
Defense!
Falcons have to have someone step up on defense here. Loose now to the corner where Champagne is. Champagne shoots and swish.
Watch their feet! They're traveling! You need to watch their feet!
McNeil with the ball. Gives it over to Shiflett, now back to McNeil. McNeil drives in, puts it up and in for two!
McNeil, 26 points now. For Montevallo.
Defense!
Fantastic showing for him.
Defense!
Gadowski drives in, now puts it out to Rusatz. Rusatz drives in, now out to Dyfel. Dyfel shoots, in and out. And Burnett now has the ball. He can take a step now and just slow down the offense for a bit.
Let's go!
Fatigue definitely setting in. Players on both teams, I think.
Moore now with the ball, gets it into, trying to get it to Gardner, but Luce just smacked it right back to Moore. Out to Shiflett. Shiflett now trying to drive in, lays it up, misses. Gardner got the rebound, put it up, missed. Gadowski gets the rebound defensively for the Buccaneers. And now it's Rusatz with the ball. Rusatz drives, jump shot in for two. Sets up the screen. McNeil shoots. It's a miss, but comes out to Gardner. And we have a foul here. That one's on Gadowski.
This is going to send Gardner to the line.
Number
72% from the stripe this season.
He's got to just calm his nerves, breathe. This one's up, and it's in. Tied game again.
Let's go, Aiden. You got this.
11 ties in this game so far.
All the Falcons are out of the box now. This one's up and in. Back onto the court. Score 68-67. It will be Christian Brothers ball. Getting up on their feet now. Ruth Sachs drives in, puts up a little floater, in for two. Ruth Sachs now taking over scoring for the Buccaneers. Gives it off to McNeil. McNeil drives, puts it out to Shiflett. Gives it back to McNeil. McNeil to Shiflett. Shiflett shoots, shorts it, and an offensive foul on the Falcons.
Personal foul, number 32, Aiden Gardner. His fourth personal, team foul, number 9.
Four players in foul trouble. Al Gardner joining the club.
And CBU, 4 of 11 from the free throw line tonight.
Trying to get loud against Daniel Luce. This one's up, and he misses.
Wow.
He didn't airball it, but fans so happy that he missed. As now the Falcons have a chance to try to get the lead. Shiflett with the ball. Personal foul on. It's a personal foul on Nick Dyfel. Dyfel. Gardner will be shooting here. This is to tie. This shot is to tie. This one is up. And cleanly in.
12th tie of the game. Incredibly close game, as we've seen.
This shot now to take the lead. This one's up. And it's cleanly in. 70-69, minute 38 left to play. Fans getting loud here in Trustmark now. Champagne over to Dyfel. Dyfel steps back, shoots, misses. Into the hands of Shiflett. Now the Falcons again can sort of slow it down, but they cannot slow it down too much. Minute five left.
McNeil looking for direction from Coach Kamara.
This is still possibly a two possession game.
8 seconds left on the shot clock.
McNeil pulls up, shoots, misses. Into the hands of Luce.
Hawkins absolutely need a stop here on this defensive side.
And Christian Brothers will call a timeout with 30 seconds left. Sir, I don't think I could handle what is going on right now. All the fans are up on their feet. I'm loving it. You know, it's what every great team needs is a great fan base. And I'd say we got a pretty great fan base here.
Falcon faithful showing up tonight.
Falcon bench started JC McNeil, Mason Schiffer, Tyler Moore, Aaron Gardner, Braxton Hillway. Looking at their faces, trying to see how they feel about this moment. I know Tyler Moore, he made up for that shot, but you know he's got to be reveling, not making that easy layup. Buccaneers ball, 30 seconds left. Gets it into Champagne. They're gonna wanna get a three off or a two off. Falcons have to play defense. Stifle drives in, puts it in for two. Falcons have to put up a two or a three here. And we're gonna see a timeout taken by Coach Kamara with 19 seconds left. Exact same thing happened last game against Shorter. Player was easy. Just was easily found a way to run up in and just lay it up in. That's what we just saw there from Nick Dyfel. But last game, Shorter didn't leave us any time. This time we have 19 seconds to move the ball down court, and we just needed two. That's
absolutely
all we need.
We saw Braxton Bertolet come up with that clutch three last week against Shorter. 20 seconds were left on the clock there. Shorter went down, put two more up.
The script has been flipped here. It's in our favor now. I'm very anxious right now. Said.
We will see Tyler Moore on the inbound. See what kind of play Coach Kamara has drawn up.
And here we go. McNeil with the ball. Shiflet.
Trying to find Braxton Bertolet.
Gets it off the press and gets stolen away. Luckily, Braxton draws the foul. Oh my gosh, ladies and gentlemen. It happens way too many times.
Struggling to close out games. Let's see if they have an answer here.
Falcons effectively now have to make a three or two to just send it to more overtime.
Christian Brothers 5-for-13 from the stripe tonight.
And now they have to either make a two and one or make the three to tie.
7 seconds left.
Thank you. Shiflett wanting Braxton to come down here, not down there in the throwing zone.
Moore is going to inbound again.
Gets it into McNeil. McNeil has to run down the court. Eiffel and Gardner chirping some words back and forth, but that's the end of the game in overtime again. Score 73-70.
Unfortunate loss for the Falcons. Falcons will move to 9-15, 7-13 in conference play. Two straight losses here in Trustmark. They'll be back here on Saturday for senior night against Union.
I'm Aiden Golden.
I'm Sarah Turner.
And good night.
Thanks for watching the Falcon Athletics Network. We'll see you Saturday.